But one of the puzzling things that people have very different opinions on is wanting to get married again for all the right or wrong reasons.
Did you push record?
Thanks for tuning in to Second Act TV. I want to welcome Rick Higgins back to Second Act, the founder and host of Mastering the Second Half. Rick, thanks so much for joining me again.
It is a pleasure to be here. Thank you.
Well, it's a pleasure having you. We've done a couple segments now. I will link to those. Rick is as I said, a fellow creator here on YouTube in our same space, all focused on the second half of life, and has some terrific topics that he explores in ways that they're just deep, funny. I just really am a fan and love what you're doing. So one of the topics. One of the videos, and I will link to it, that really got my attention is the one you did on marriage. You know, so many of us have started over again, have divorced after, you know, a long-term relationship, long-term marriage. But one of the puzzling things that people have very different opinions on is wanting to get married again for all the right or wrong reasons. And you had a great take, and I want you to talk about that. Tell me about that segment and your feelings about it.
Well, I kind of purposely clickbaity titled it that I will never get married again, but it doesn't mean what you think. But that is actually the truth. I will never get married again. And the problem is because of what marriage was defined as. You know, when you're in your 20s, it's defined you're supposed to find a partner, get married, have kids, buy a house. There's a whole plan. It involves, you know, religious characters, caterers, and lawyers. That was what I chased for a very long time. I have been married and divorced twice because I was chasing somebody else's definition of marriage. Now, I am in a very great relationship right now, have been for the past 6 years, and she and I have both agreed we will never get married. However, we are married. We call each other spouse. We call each other husband and wife, sometimes partner. Sometimes it's hard because those words are what society uses to define who you are and what you have. And we help them along by saying husband and wife. But what we have didn't require a trip to the courthouse. It didn't require another definition. We know what marriage is for us. And so for me, finally learning that the pursuit was not of the definition of society's version of marriage, but just to be happy, just to find somebody and be happy with on our terms. And once I discovered that, I kind of really wish I had a Wayback Machine and could do it right the first time.
Yeah, no, I agree. And I've been married twice. My first one, I call it a practice marriage. That I was young, 22, you know, engaged 4 weeks after we met, you know, married 6 months later, divorced, you know, a couple months after that. So that's my practice one. I was married for 25 years. And the same thing, just really living up to all those societal expectations to where I don't ever want to go through that again. And like you, I've been in a longer relationship now, 8 years, and we both agreed we don't want to get married again. But we do feel like, you know, we live like a married couple, even though, although in our case, we're not living together, not yet anyway. It's something that we'll probably do down the road for different reasons why. But I bring this up in that there are so many different ways to have a wonderful relationship, even though people might not be able to understand it. And you brought up something good just now when you said it's something interesting about helping people along define this, you know, that sometimes you even call each other spouse or maybe like in our case, we don't, if they say, oh, well, your husband did this, or, you know, like a waiter or a waitress, or, well, your wife over here, we don't, you know, correct them or anything. Mm-hmm. But there is, yeah, we don't want that those expectations on us. So I'm wondering too, if there's, you know, the viewers watching, you know, what is your experience with this? What are your feelings on this? Because there's many, many ways to be happy to where I think really the formality of marriage, because of the way we were raised also, can actually ruin a good relationship.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. What do you think? Very much, absolutely. And I know some of the problems we've had, there's sort of been with family. I mean, sometimes my family's very traditional Southern upbringing. It's taken them quite a while to understand. They just call her Nikki instead of trying to figure out what pronouns to use. So they're kind of on board. The rest of society, though, it can sometimes be hard. You know, we'll be asked questions, well, don't you want to live happily ever after? How can you do that if you're not married? How easy is it to get divorced? It's the piece of paper. The fact that I had a giant catered party doesn't change anything as far as longevity. I know what I want. I know how long of a relationship I want. I am not in it so I can count the years from this ceremony till death. I am in it because I am in love and I want to share my life. Whatever aspects of our lives we want to share and when. So I get that people need definitions, they need to have limits, and they like to count. And we try to help them as much as we can to put our relationship into their terms, but that's for descriptive purposes. What we have, what we live, is on our terms. And it has made us, because she's also been married and divorced a couple of times, we finally realized this is what we should be pursuing. It is, we should be pursuing happiness, not check boxes.
Yeah. At our age, I guess there is an argument to be made because we do live in a, a law-driven society that, especially now with COVID, if he ends up, and I've had this thought because he was feeling bad last week. It's like, what if he has to go to the hospital and then I'm not his wife? How do I get to talk? I want to make sure I'm able to, but these are all legal things you can put in place that don't require a marriage certificate. It depends on, I guess, your individual circumstances, but maybe there is a reason, tax reasons or something. But the whole...
We recently were filling out a residency visa for Spain, and there's a very conservative country. And in order to be put together on that application, we had to be married, and we weren't. We discovered, and different states may have this, in the state of Florida where I live, they have something called a domestic partnership. It's issued by the same group that issues corporate licenses. We're in essence a corporation that are legally allowed to make decisions for each other, and that was good enough legal-wise to get our residency visa. So, but I do understand a lot of people, the world is geared around the legalities of marriage, and, it can be tough. It can be very tough.
Yeah. No, I agree. I think it's an interesting discussion, especially at this time, it's on our channel because we have done a lot on gray divorce and, why are men blindsided? Or why do women file for, people are fed up, lots of men, lots of women with the whole idea of marriage and what it's meant and what it's done. And yes, there are marriages that are happy and wonderful. And my God bless you. You have what we all aspire to. It's just not realistic for everybody. And to be held to those standards can be harmful, emotionally harmful to someone when they don't feel they're good enough. What do you think?
No. Oh, very much so. Marriage is not one size fits all. Marriage is what fits you. And as long as it helps you, doesn't harm others, why not pursue that? I don't quite understand why everyone has to fit into the same mold. I don't disparage against people who follow traditional values. I'm very happy for them if they find happiness.
Right.
I think that just should be for everybody. And, I get when people are told they can't get married, that they want to get married just because they were told they couldn't. But when you have a choice, I will always choose happiness over what I'm supposed to do.
Yeah. No, exactly. It's funny, we were out, it just struck me again, this whole indulgence with marriage, but we were just at our favorite neighborhood bar, and, you always kind of like cheers, and you end up talking to everybody, and, so you guys been married, we're not married, or, we've been together, and it's like the woman looks at me, and she's like, where's the ring? And it's funny, I didn't say anything, but I just took offense to that. It's like, why do we have to explain this? Why do I have to explain? Or why would you even ask? So anyway, it's an interesting, interesting topic. I love the video that you did. Again, it just raises a lot of thought. It's thought-provoking. And it does apply to lots of us on some level. So thank you for doing that. Rick, we're almost at the end. Anything else you want to add here?
No, my only thought is just go be happy. Find what works for you.
Yeah. No, that's true. Well, I look forward to continuing conversations with you, especially in the realm of questions that women have, you know, get some honest, transparent answers from, you know, just your average guy, again, to start conversations that will hopefully help us on our quest to find love, date, stay married, whatever. But I thank you for being here, and I look forward to having you back on Second Act.
Thanks for having me again, Silke. Always a pleasure.
Bye. If you haven't done so already, please be sure to subscribe to our channel. The button is right over here. Just click on through to YouTube. When you see that little bell right next to the subscribe button, hit that too, and we'll notify you every time we launch a new video. See you next time.